And now we will learn how to record paying for expenses and buying things. It's so simple. First, use the register of the account that the money came from. Second, record all relevant information. And third, check the results in the trial balance. For example, June 4th, paid Verizon $250 from the M&T bank account with check number 1. Let's take a look at how we would record this. We open the M&T bank register. We put the date as June 4th. The check number is 1, and QuickBooks suggests check number 1. Now, whom did we pay? We paid Verizon. So we click the payee list and go down to the vendor section, and we find Verizon. Or at least we're supposed to find, here it is, Verizon. Good. Now, why did we pay Verizon? The account that we choose. See, when you click account, you get a list of all the accounts in the chart of accounts, but the account we choose reflects the reason why we paid. In this case, we paid telephone expense. Now, it is a payment, and you have to be very careful if you're decreasing this bank account to put it in the payment column. And the amount is $250. So I type in $250 and I push tab. Then when I record it, notice the balance of the M&T bank account goes down to $550. When we look at the results in the trial balance, you can see M&T bank has decreased to $550 and telephone expense showed up for the first time on the trial balance as $250. Let's record the next transaction. June 5th, paid AT&T $150 from the Chase bank account. And since this is the first check from the Chase bank account, it'll be check number 1. Let's take a look at how to record it. We can close the other windows and open the Chase bank register. The date was June 5th. The check number was check number 1. It's the first check we're writing from the Chase bank account. And whom did we pay? In this case, we paid AT&T. Now, why did we pay AT&T? Well, we paid them for our telephone expense. And make sure the money amount goes in the payment column, not the deposit column, because this is a decrease to Chase Bank. When we click record, you'll notice that the Chase Bank balance has decreased to $350. When we open the main report, the trial balance, you can see that telephone expense is now up to $400. And we can double-click that total telephone expense and see the reason it's $400 was because we paid Verizon $250 for telephone service from the M&T bank account. And we paid AT&T on June 5th from the Chase bank account $150. And that explains why total telephone expense so far is $400. Let's try one more. June 6th, paid $50 cash to Dr. Kirk for dog medicine, and he gave you receipt number 55667. Well, if we paid him cash, that means that the money came from your wallet. Click here to open the register. The date was June 6th. The receipt number was 55667. The payee was our good friend, Dr. Kirk. And the reason we paid him was vet bills. Vet bills. Make sure you put the money in the payment column because this decreases the cash you have. I believe it was $50. So when we click record, you should have $150 in your wallet or in the cash on hand. When we look at the results in the trial balance, you can see that vet bills shows up for the first time as $50. And you can see the cash on hand in your wallet has decreased from $200 to $150. Now, there's one more thing I want to mention. The profit and loss report will now be clear. Let's close out the other two windows, and from the icon bar, click profit and loss. Now we can see the difference between the money that came in and the money that went out. Right now, we only have $1,500, and it's specifically for bartending income. We have telephone expense and vet bills equaling $450. So the difference between the money that came in since we started recording in June and the money that went out is $1,050. And this $1,050 is distributed across the different bank accounts, such as Chase Bank, M&T, and Cash on Hand Wallet. You may also notice some other similarities between the profit and loss and the trial balance. First, you can notice that we can set a from date and a to date and limit what shows up as a result in the profit and loss. For example, even though we had transactions from June 1 until June 6th, we can tell QuickBooks, show us the results of transactions between June 2nd and June 5th. After we click refresh, notice the numbers change because it only includes transactions between those dates. We can fix this by clicking the pull down arrow in the top left, scroll all the way up, and again ask QuickBooks to show us the results of all transactions regardless of date. Also, just like the trial balance, you can double click one of the summary numbers and a detail will open up. For example, this is the same telephone expense we saw a moment ago in the trial balance. You can double click and you can see that we open telephone expense. We can see every check that we made for telephone expense and the running balance and the date. Now, some of you might have made a mistake while you were following along and putting in the information. Don't worry. You can change anything that you saved at any time. And at the moment you save the changes, the results in the reports will fix themselves immediately. For example, let's open the M&T bank register and let's open the trial balance. Notice right now, cash in Chase Bank is $350 and bartending income is only $1,500. But if we went back to the M&T register and we changed, for example, let's click and let's change this field. Now, to change something that you saved, all you have to do is click back into the field that you saved it, overtype it with the new information. For example, I put 1,000,000 instead of 1,000. Okay. Then when I click record, the only thing that will happen is that QuickBooks will tell you, you have changed the transaction. Do you want to record the changes? If you click yes, you can look at the trial balance and now notice bartending income is now well over $1,000,000 and the balance of M&T Bank is almost $1,000,000. Don't worry, you could always change it back. When you come back, you can change any part of the transaction that you already recorded. You can click here and make it a different income account. You can click here and make it a different person involved in the transaction. You can even change the date. But look what happens as soon as you change it back to what it was supposed to be. Again, when you try to save it, you'll get a warning that you changed something. Do you want to record the changes? When you click yes, all the numbers go back to exactly what they were. So don't worry about making a mistake. Just go back to the place that you made the mistake and type over with exactly what it was supposed to be.